Hello, I am Grandmaster Mihail Marin from Romania, and I invite you to a journey through the tactical French world. In principle, one may think that the French opening is a positional and even boring opening, because black mainly plays for some solid structures in the center. But this is only partly true. Actually, there are a lot more combinations possible than one may imagine. And this happens for two reasons. For white, it is easy to achieve space advantage and optical advantage. But okay, black's position remains quite solid. So in order to achieve success, it is many times necessary to sacrifice, to make a combination. Otherwise, the position would remain just strategically balanced. For black, it's a similar situation. He has not so much space. At some point, if he wants to breathe freer, then he has to do something concrete. He has to open the position somehow, and tactics often come to help. I have been fascinated by the French opening from Black's point of view ever since the match Korchnoi-Spassky, that was the final candidates match in 1977. Korchnoi played the French opening quite a lot there with very good results. And my fascination was, of course, provoked not only because of the structures, but also of the huge complications which could arise. We should understand that my sympathy goes for black. But at the same time, you may notice that whites and blacks combination, they occupy similar amounts of space in the database. And I have done this because of two main reasons. First of all, when playing with black, we should also know what we should be afraid of, what we should avoid. And secondly, there are many combinations for white where the questions are mainly asked from black's point of view. I mean, finding defenses, even refutations, getting equality or even an advantage after the thematical sacrifice. So we can be confronted with such such combinations very frequently. So we have to know how to react against them. So in principle, this DVD should mainly help players who have the French opening in their repertoire with black, but can offer some inspiration also to E4 players who don't have a clue to how to break such a fortress. When organizing the material, I have considered two basic structures which are really typical for the French defense. And doubtlessly, the most typical is the structure with a blocked center, which can arise via several move orders. First of all, there is e5. Then there are the systems with knight d2 and knight f6. There is also this system which I like slightly less because black delays his counterplay with c5. After knight c3, again, we have bishop before e5, which is the old main line. Nowadays, knight f6 is more popular, and again, we can get this blocked structure. I will now explain how I have organized, how I have classified the combinations on this DVD. First, I have looked at some tactical blows from white's point of view. The first group includes sacrifices on the king side. quite frequently the Black King is there, and this mainly is mainly equivalent to starting an attack. Even though, as explained in the introduction to this section, all these sacrifices are not similar. Depending on the square where white sacrifices, play can take a different character. Then we have the sacrifices against the central structure. Okay, this can include also the c4 pawn. If in some systems, black blocks the king side, the queen side completely. These have more of a strategic character. It's about space, about clearing the path for our pawns, aiming for a mobile structure. But of course, there are some elements regarding the enemy king's safety involved too. Black has his own possibilities to sacrifice. And let's take, for instance, this structure, where white has a coherent center. First of all, there are the sacrifices against the central pawns, and mainly this one. It usually is a sacrifice of a pawn for two pawns. Well, this can arise in such variations. Queen b6, let's say, and then black plays f6, f takes e5, gets castled, and somehow this king doesn't feel so safe. So then a sacrifice could open the center to black's favor. There are also similar blows connected with this square, and also, as we'll see, with the base of the white structure, especially in structures like this, when black simply attacks on the queen side. Then we'll switch to a strategic issue, which is white's main plan based on f5. We'll see the dangers for black there, but also his possible reactions, which even though f5 is a strategic move, we'll see that play can become very concrete, sharp, tactical, even violent sometimes. Black is not forced to just sit and wait on the king side. Even though this is white's territory, there is such a plan of king side expansion, mainly based on g5 possible. This is quite a special case, and it doesn't already work, but under certain circumstances it can be a very important method. Not least, there is the problem of this bishop, which can easily become a bad bishop in the endgame. There are slow possibilities of activating it, which don't really fit into this DVD, because this is mainly a toolbox, a tactical toolbox. But we'll see some concrete circumstances where the bishop can be a very dangerous attacking piece or an element maintaining black's initiative. So these are mainly the categories. I believe I didn't forget anyone, any of them. Anyway, they all have individual introductions. And now we'll move to the second typical French structure, the Isolani, which usually arises after these moves. Well, actually, even in the generally solid and boring exchange variation, I like playing c5, and actually I had very good results with it. It's basically the same structure. Or even after bishop d3, I react with c5 when there is nothing better than taking and transposing to the same. I should just say a few things about the move orders. Here, okay, there is no such thing as an optimal move for black. If black develops the knight on the best square, knight f, the best, most active square, then against bishop b5, he has to react with bishop d7, because after, otherwise, after castling, he will have the problems evacuating his king from the center. Bishop d7, which exchanges this bishop. The black bishop can be an attacking bishop in this system. There is also a6, but white can avoid this by playing bishop b5 at once. Of course, there is a6 here, and c5. If ed, ed, then again, white doesn't have bishop b5, and black is most likely going to develop his knight on f6. But the problem is that a6 is a slow move, and then white could think of keeping the tension in the center. And finally, one of my favorites is this line, where okay, black didn't exchange anything, didn't waste any tempo, but his knight is on e7. But okay, the knight has perspectives from that square too. These are the only structures examined in this tactical toolbox. Of course, there are other structures. For instance, these positions without pawns in the center, because okay, this pawn will disappear soon. Okay, this can also this structure can also arise after, let's say, d takes a4 now on the next move, when black exchanges the d4 pawn. But these are not really typical for the French. They can be typical for several other openings, such as the Scandinavian, the Caro-Kann, also some Sicilians. So this is not really what I understand by typical French structures. I have mentioned about my long time love or fascination with the French opening. But for a long time, this has only accumulated as platonic love, because it was not before, not so many years ago, that I started to play it on a regular basis. And I, even from inside, from inside this French world, I continue finding it quite, quite beautiful opening. Sometimes you can lose some bad games, but when you win, what a feel. All this having been said, I will leave you now to step by step investigate the tactical possibilities in the French opening. Good luck.